your fires all die out. All you know just turns to ash, and your life goes slipping, spinning into doubt. Sunshine trapped inside your heart, cold and lost and in the dark. Looking back on all this, nobody was there. Nothing left to lose, gotta find the you that's hidden deep, deep down. And like the fire in yourself, never be afraid to fall. Throw yourself into it, victory's waiting for you.
Go fight, show your energy.
Don't slow down, no time to waste. Nothing's stopping you now, it's gonna be your day. Hopes and wishes never fade. Fight to make them stronger, nothing will take them from you.
Go fight, show your energy.
There's a feeling deep inside, let it be your prayer. Show me the power you can hide.
Hello everyone, welcome back to 795. I am back after a considerable amount of grinding. It's more like getting more accustomed to the battle system. And I have grinded on the first mission that you can do, the one with the two droids. I grinded for I did a whole bunch of playing it over just so I can get used to the battle system. And I spent a couple of my experience points instead of going for levels. I decided because the whole you lose race points if you're over leveled kind of thing, I didn't want to just put points in experience. So I went instead and I spent it on my skill points. I got extra large support and then I maxed blade savvy on myself because, well, damage. And I maxed out continued awakening enhancement just because it didn't last long enough last time and I was just like, oh shit, it's over. So I changed that. I increased her preempt and counter-strike ranks, and I gave her a heal, so now she can actually heal the party. So I'm quite confident this time will not end up like last time, and I'll be able to meet all the conditions except for two of them in the first go. So yeah, we're gonna start the battle. I still love that player turn. In the name of the summoner Folth, I summon power to thee. I'm ready to make an offer of heaven or hell to these foes. You can feel the power gathering in the air. Wait, no, it's being conjured. This must be the summon arts I've heard of. Okay, folks, let's make a good impression in each of these blobs. Yep, oh god, the tutorials, I forgot. These tutorials are still gonna pop up. We've seen them last episode, so I'm just gonna cut through them because, there's no point in rereading what we already know. So, I believe the first condition was to get 2 kills for everybody, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have Folth come over here and side attack this guy, hold up, I was using his rod in the other mission. Holy sh- 32 damage. I like. Oh! Whoops! Well, there he goes. Instantly died. Well, there was nothing that could be done for that guy, I'm sorry. Regrettably, he instantly died. Alright, so I'm gonna use a throw attack. Alright. Oh, dear lord, what is this crit rate? Well, I'm gonna give this one to Spinal, so that way she can get her points up. You know what, actually, I'm gonna change her position, move her up a little bit behind Fold, and switch to use magic to kill this guy. Frosting! And there he goes. And holy crap, that's a lot of MP to get from another kill. So, I'm going to use Yuha, and I'm going to... Whoops, wrong place. And I'm going to... Yep, I'm just going to use her gun, and I'm just going to shoot this guy. And that's my turn. I've used up all my points, and I realized that I left myself facing in a possibly bad direction? Oh, they retreat? Yeah, that's a side attack for me. Oh god, please don't kill it. Okay. I'm definitely gonna give that to Spine. Oh, I'm gonna be taking it. I have to say, they're doing incredibly less damage. I love how they just turn around to make sure that they don't get hit. Yep, attack range weapons of statuses. Yep, read that before. So now she gets her second kill. 15. That's 75% rate. Let's see if I can get her into a sort of side stats here for this. Oh wow, okay. I did the same amount, so I guess magic wasn't the key. Anyways, that's her two kills, so she's done. She's done with that. And the only people who aren't done is... basically everyone else hasn't finished. Alright, he's dead. That's one for her. I lost a brave point because she's level 4. Ooh, okay, so this... alright, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna first aid myself. Yeah, that's how many times I've done the tutorial fight. I've done it enough times that I have 31 bandages, and I actually sold half my bandages beforehand. So, I think I have like 60 bandages or so, and that mission gives 3 or something. And I sold them all, primarily. Oh, well, I have my... Awakening it has to, but I don't need it right now. Alright, so... how can I do this where I won't instantly kill this guy? Okay, so I won't kill him instantly. Or will I? Oops, hold up. Alright, let's do this. See how much damage we can get off with this. Absolutely nothing, okay. Forget the summon assist then. I just can't cut him. He's gonna counterattack though. Yeah. I might have to switch my weight to defend so I don't kill this. Because I want the other guys to get it. Okay, I'm gonna have her face this way just in case. What is his range? It's not favorable either way. I'll have her defend this way. Alright, on turn. Is he gonna try and use magic? Yep. Yep, that was quite a shock. Oh! Somebody's going into her preemptive range. Oh, I didn't trigger. She has like a 40% chance to attack first when she gets attacked in melee range. But, I guess I had a bad roll that time. But fortunately I crit him, I mean, that's still a thing, I crit him. Yep, summon magic. And now we're going to have him kill this one. Which one? Oops, hold up, switch to the swords. That's not gonna happen. That is more likely to happen. Alright. Another brave point lost because he's level 4. Now let's see, what can we do to make things slightly more fun? I probably should have went for a bow mastery just because her damage is pretty bad. It's not bad, but it's not good. And she doesn't have a very high rate with, well, high damage ability with either of them, so it's kind of sad. And she missed! Alright, so let's see, how are we gonna deal with this guy? Should I just inscribe promise him? Just to be that guy? Just instantly use my inscribe promise? Oh, hold up, I gotta do weapon change. Twenty-six damage, 110% rate. I could probably lower his health. Probably. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stand here in front, and then I'm gonna use my angelic angel shine flames, take him down a tick. Lower his health a little bit. And then I'm going to wait in front like this. And then she's just gonna one hit him. Alright, that's her second kill. Now I need to get two kills. Also, she has her awakening. He doesn't, sadly. Well, actually, I don't need two kills. I need one kill. It's one and one. And I also need to kill this guy before the mission ends, so... I'm probably gonna have to bait him out, because it doesn't look like he's gonna move for us, unless he has magic, then he might move for us. Okay, everybody's active, so yeah, end turn. Yeah, he went for a side attack. Yep, I was blocking this time. Okay, Alfred's gonna get hit, yep. That's a shot to his system. But he'll be fine. He's not in critical. As long as you don't get in critical, I can be fine with this, even if I don't get the other requirement. I think I'm gonna have to come back for Pekko, because I'm not getting him this one. I don't think so, because he's too far up, and these guys have come down all the way. So it seems very unlikely that I'll be getting him. I almost did eight, because the mission requirement is to kill all these things, and the moment I kill the last one, it's just gonna end. Alright, you know what, just because... Oh, right, I forgot about the Brave Order, whoops. Alright, so we're just gonna hit him. And holy free, holy, that's a lot of damage. Alright. And now he can come in and just lightly tap him on the shoulder and instantly kill him. And then this one leaves, and I guess this one's mine. I'm just gonna awakening just to see how long I can stay in awakening now. Alright, because she also has to resonance. Oh, I don't even think I can get her to resonance. Okay, then that's awkward. I mean, I could just kill him with this attack, I'm not gonna lie. Or not. But can I get behind him to kill him? Yep. Now I'm going to kill him with this attack. Or not. Alright, let's do it. Awakening. I do hope that I'm technically still in range to hit him. Because I just remember the whole unit one space requirement for using bows. Oh, it's even... Okay, so I can move. Hold up. Let me see if I can get it from the side. I mean, I could technically shoot him into that, but I need to see how much damage I'm going to do before I shoot. 30? Wow. Holy crap, these odds are not favorable. How much does this do? Not enough. Doesn't do enough. She's also in a very bad position, I would say. Still only do weapon exchange. Okay then. Yep. Alright, let's see. Let's see how much damage this guy can do to me. Oh, he's retreating. Yep. There goes the inspiration. Oh crap, don't tell me you retreated out of my range. Okay, no, he didn't. Alright, he's dead now. So Yep, battle ends. I'll just have to redo that and get him. Alright, I managed to get everything except to defeat more than two foes at once, and that's only because I don't have a multi-hit. I don't have any AoEs, so that would have been physically impossible. So everybody gets 1,310 EXP. I got some ores, I got an FA, and I've got some illustrations and anime stills, yay. Finally stunned the freak. This is a party invitation I could have done without. Okay guys, just behave, and you can tell me what this was all about when I get you to HQ. Careful, it's not safe to go near them yet. Huh? What? Lightning. I can't believe you still had enough strength left to do that. Oh no, it's getting away. Ugh. Hey, we can do this the easy way or the hard way. You'd better knock it off. I don't think it cares. Oh no, civilian. The freak show is lashing out indiscriminately. This has to stop. He's attacking everyone. Look out! Ah. I'm sorry, I can't do your own voice. It's one of those things. Are you okay? Does it hurt? Oh, I'm sorry. This happened because you were protecting me. Oh, it's alright. It's alright. It doesn't hurt much. But don't worry. I'm a summoner. It takes more than something like this to really hurt me. So don't cry, okay? I'm totally fine. Oh. Okay. Thank you. You're welcome. Okay, spill it. It got you good, didn't it? Damn straight, it hurts like crazy. Plus one for honestly, eventually. Thanks for laying it all out in the assist. The police will search for the ones that got away. Once we know where they're at, I'll make sure we contact Eucross. Right, thanks. Oh, and thanks to you too, Yunhua. You really saved our bacon out there. I have to say she did. That gun is pretty effective. Why so silent? Are you angry? No, I'm just trying to process the idiocy I just witnessed. On top of throwing yourself into that conflict before even understanding the situation properly, you somehow managed to corral me into that mess too, and got me to follow your command. Never mind. Nothing you can say will make that more rational to me. I'll just regard it as a net gain in my experience as I now have a better idea of your true character. Yeah, right. Can we return to the tour now? I'd like to see as much as possible of the city hotspots before dark. But isn't it still considered morning? I don't think you have anything to worry about. As you wish. So yes, now we continue the tour of the city, and before that I'm going to save my game, just in case. There we go, making a different save, and what's this? Oh, apparently you can leave the map, I didn't know that, that's quite new. Alright, let's see what's new here. Why did the Takeshi do such... Takeshi, sorry, I'm so used to saying Takeshi. The Takeshi do such a weird and silly thing. Usually we get along so well together, I wonder what happened. I don't know, don't ask me. So we're going out to the outskirts of the city? Oh wow. So we're even going to city... There's a west city center? What? Oops, maybe I should have went through the other side. No. Wait. Huh? Okay, I'm confused. So you can exit from either side. Oh, I see. I was too focused on the idea that we're still doing stuff in the city. We're actually leaving outside. I see. But no one has a fearless tread. Oh, warless. It looks like fearless from my side. Hey-ho. Alright, shipping out the best veggies today. Okay, let's see what's over here then. My, what a beautiful light in your soul. I would so dearly love to be the cause of someone like you. Oh, sorry, job's taken. Get lost. Yeah, Metropa Colony Verdia Town. This is the Metropa Colony. Hey ho! Good weather and a good breeze, the best kind of day to get a mountain of work done. The atmosphere here is quite different from the city. The lush greenery of Metropa is a nice contrast to the urban environment of the city. Those who were born there seem to feel more settled and relaxed than city dwellers. If we venture deeper into this area, you'll be able to see a huge farm. So this is Beast World Metropa. This beautiful other world is home to mythical beasts, fairies, and demi-humans. I see. For an investigator, she sure seems indifferent. What's her deal? Yeah, she seems to not give any fucks. Let's see, the Superior Colony. What's the matter? You look like something freaked you out. That forest, over there, I'm getting a very odd feeling from it. It's bright daylight, but it's so heavily wooded, the light doesn't penetrate to the ground. Ah, I was just about to introduce you. Introducing me to that forest? Yeah, it'd be quite dangerous for you to not to know about it. So I wanted to give you some background. Dangerous? That is the Crystal Forest, where many native to the spirit world spirits dance. Sorry, it confused me a little bit on that phrasing. Spirit is the other world inhabited by all manner of spirit beings. The environment there is different from that of Limbalm. Creatures from Limbalm can't survive in spirit by themselves. And the verse is also true. Wait a minute, I don't understand what you mean. Didn't you say that people native to Superith lived in that forest? Superith natives can't survive in Limbalm by themselves because they must find a way to obtain the magical power they need to sustain themselves. Once they solve that problem, they're fine. They found that the Crystal Forest holds power to store magic contained in moonlight. Neat, huh? And that is why there's a large concentration of Superith natives there. I understand now. But those magical properties make the forest dangerous for Limbalm humans who enter it. Everyone knows at least one story of someone being turned into a ghost there. Creepy. That's... No, nothing. Never mind. Let's move along. Okay, well then, next is... Land within Limbalm that has been taken away from Limbalm. A place where Limbalm humans cannot even enter for long, let alone live. Isn't that tantamount to being invaded by the other worlds? I'd say she's not far from the truth, but she's not wrong. It's not right, I would say. Okay, so here. We're right now. Do you need something? Another conversation. Sultan Colony, Furai Town. This is the Sultan Colony area, right? The streetscape makes it rather obvious. It looks like Japan, well, considering that they're Oni or Yokai? Yeah, it's Yokai. It would make sense. This is probably the only place with homes made of wood and paper. I'm impressed. What else do you know about Sultan? Sultan is a world where Oni and Yokai... Oh, okay, so Oni and Yokai got... So it is both of them. Live amongst humans. Yes. I wouldn't say I know a lot, but it's the other world I'm most familiar with. The Silver Year organization receives more than a little help from Sultan. Oh, so you don't need to be shown around here more then. Also, since we're talking about Sultan here, Savorle isn't the only world they interact with. I've seen towns like this in other cities here and there too. I see. This is the only known other world where humans live in addition to ours. Dealing with people who don't look much different seems to make it easier to trust. What is that sweet smell? Oh, that's adzuki. I'd know that smell anywhere. Just like they're making a sweet bean paste. Yes, it's often boiled, sweetened, and eaten with rice cakes or things that like that as a dessert. Seems to be a girl treat, though. Way too sweet for me. I see. If you want to check it out, we can stop by the shop over there. In the middle of a mission? No, I don't believe that would be an appropriate use of our time. So let's move on already. Wait for me! Why are you suddenly walking so quickly? Hurry up, or I'm leaving you behind. Wait up! Busy, so busy. Alright, anywhere else? Oop. I think that's everywhere. Maybe there's something down here that I haven't seen. You know, I'm just gonna use the left and right to see if I've missed anything. Alright, I don't think I've missed anything, so let's go back to the city. Yep, there it is. This seems, I think that's potential another fight, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save the game. And I'm going to call this a part. Yeah, I know. We had a lot more dialogue than combat. But it's the beginning of the game. Yeah, I admit. So, I'm gonna call it a part here. And next time when we come back, we're gonna start this new event. This is most likely a battle, because the battle events are listed as events. So, thank you all for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, evening, or morning, wherever you are, at any time, whenever you're watching this. And, goodbye.